Hello, everybody. So today let's have a few minutes to discuss about the role of antibiotics and microbiota and how these two important characters can interact among them. I would say that, as you well know, microbiota is nowadays considered a real organ within our intestinal tract. And this organ is able to provide protection because of barrier function. It is providing also immunological function as well as metabolic function. And I truly believe that in the next future, metabolism and microbiota will definitely be the major point in this field. What are antibiotics doing to microbiota? First of all, antibiotics are not usually are thought to act only in a single at a single germ level, and that is actually true because the mechanism of action are very precise and well known. But there's never one only microbe that is aimed, that is targeted by an antibiotic, but actually there is a class of germs, families, species of germs that are modified by antibiotics. For this reason, we can say that antibiotics can affect the entire gut microbiota, and there are studies showing clearly this in babies, in adults, and we can imagine that the way that the microbiota respond to the antibiotic is could be very different. There are people that can recover, there are people that never recover, there are some people that take some time to recover from a shot of antibiotic. And new studies coming mainly from the Northern Europe or United States are actually telling us that the use of antibiotics at early stages in life are associated with diabetes, obesity, and as well as other extreme intestinal disorders. And that is very important for us to be to consider. That is the reason why we need also potential therapy to counteract somehow the dangerous role of antibiotics. That is very easy to understand and to consider for antibiotic-associated diarrhea, the most diffuse disease associated to the use of antibiotics. And you know that among the antibiotics-associated diarrhea, there is the Clostridium difficile infection. Nowadays, this infection is killing people, mainly elderly people, and for some of them, the minority of them, the only possibility to take care of them is a new potential therapy on microbiota, which is the microbiota transplantation. Microbiota transplantation is taking care completely of the microbiota, is almost substituting the microbiota of the affected patient, and it somehow take this microbiota close related to the one of the donor. This way, people with Clostridium difficile colitis can be safely sent home because the disease, the Clostridium difficile colitis, is cured by fecal transplantation. Of course, in other diseases, different than Clostridium difficile, nowadays, fecal transplantation can be considered an option, but as we know right now, this is the most powerful way for us to modify and take care of the microbiota. There are other possibilities that are very well used also throughout the world, which is the use of the probiotics, the use of prebiotics eventually, and I believe that the future for us as a gastroenterologist and for all other people that are working on the team of the microbiota is to push the attention to the diet and diet and microbiota modification, which is, I believe, the very first level of action. Following diet, there is, of course, exercise, and there are also probiotics and prebiotics that need to be studied with in a better way, I would say, compared to the past. But still, we have very good examples of indications where probiotics and or prebiotic have a clear medical role.